there is big interaction between genes and environmental factors, and also there is much more involvement from the other systems of the body. I worked on immunological impairments in children with autism in Macedonia, and genetics also, immunogenetics, and I can tell you that we found a lot of immunological disturbances in the body of children with autism, and also we found gastrointestinal disorders. Or sometimes they have diarrhea, sometimes they have constipation, and the diarrhea and constipation make them a lot of troubles in their behavior, which is socially not so good for the other people who don't know a lot about autism. Because when the parents go with the child in the market, and the child starts to have tantrums, to screaming, and other people in the market thinks that this child is not very well educated, or it's silly, but it's not true. That child has some problems. Probably he has problem in his stomach, because there is one theory about gut, leaky gut syndrome. A lot of children with autism has leaky gut syndrome, which means that their gut doesn't work properly. And I will not go now into details. As I told you, it's a polygenic disorder. There are many theories about causes of autism. I will mention some of them. For example, we found abnormal cerebral blood flow in some areas of the brain. Also, sometimes high fever can be problematic. High fever. Parents said that the child in the first year of life has some problems with high fever because of some infection of the throat or bronchitis. Then some of the people, of the parents said that their children have birth trauma or